psychic attacks, penis and bum visions, and more. True stories. This is serious. Please watch to the end. Believe me, no one is immune to this.
Hi, all. I wanted to take a minute to make a video and break away from my little hiatus to tell you something that happened to a friend of mine. Let me back up by saying that the second video I think I made of the beginning of my true story videos, I said my family and friends were walked away from me. I was told this off the universe. I understood the situation, why they were pulled away from me. One was to keep them from being attacked because I was under attack. But at the same time, it took my support factor away from me. And they knew that too. You can't fight Sadie Hall in those cases. Well, since making this video or these videos on YouTube, I have said it several times in my videos. Watch your thoughts. Be careful, because I have a feeling from what I'm hearing that people are being walked away from me again. Now, I can name names. I mean, they have told me who has been going, you know, under any kind of attack when it comes to me or whatever out there. And I just figured, well, these now are enlightened beings, and so they should know better. I'm not going to go chasing after them if they don't want to have anything to do with me. I can't make them. It's like you can bring a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. So again, you know, I've noticed that the decline in interest and attitude, and it didn't bother me. I figured, well, you know, I've got enough to do with people that are coming on board. No big deal. But when they start attacking people physically, it's a big deal. It's one thing to take them away from me by keeping you sidetracked in other things that you have to do or telling you not to have anything to do with whatever when it comes to me, okay? But now I'm having people tell me they're under attack, and that is just drawing a line to me. This is what happened. I had a friend, or have a friend. Now, these are enlightened women, and so because of that, and there's a guy too, a couple of them, that have been telling me about what they've been going through. Some of them I've been asking for their help, and because of me asking for their help, they are being subjected to. And it's not me, okay? Let me stop by saying this has been going on for thousands of years. It's not me. This is just an excuse that they want to use. Okay, the first one. Now, there's a gentleman on YouTube. I think it's Spirit Speak, that he's got a YouTube channel. He's been under attack for 16 years. I've been over 20 years. I meet people all over the place through emails that tell me about their life and what they've been going through and the situations that they're having. So I know it's just something that's been going on for a long time, and I'm just being told things as an excuse so they can keep doing it. I asked Anne to help me in regards to, you know, getting me out there more, because she said people need to know this about the spirit possession thing, that this is not a joke. This is serious. And in doing so, I did ask her. She agreed. And the next thing I know, she was telling me that the very next day or day after, she went through a horrendous self-doubt, self-denial. I mean, it was just, she said it was terrible. All the feelings that she had, I mean, anything negative that you can imagine about how you would feel about yourself, they went after her, and they just dumped on her. At the same time, I know that there was some guidance around her that were doing all they could to protect her. So when she emailed me and told me, I said, of course it's not you. They want to make sure that they win, and you, you know, don't. So we got through that. Then Janelle tells me, and these are all women now that have been putting their videos out through me on their spirit possession or spirit attack, okay? Janelle tells me that one night she's meditating and she gets this message to go and join up with them to go against Charlene. And she says, get out of here. You know, just get out of here and leave me alone. Now she tells me today that she's having, or yesterday too, that she's having attacks to her body. Prickling feeling, tingling feeling, and even in areas that is what you would call a sexual attack. So this happened earlier this week with Jackie. This happened with Jackie first before Janelle. But I printed out Jackie's letter to let you know that this is not a game. This is very real out there. And I get messages all the time in my mind, don't have anything to do with him. Don't have anything to do with her. And I just tell them, go away. Leave me alone. You know, there is no reason for you to say this to me. I know these are nice people and you're just being hateful. Well, the other day I get an email from Jackie after not seeing her on Facebook, and she's on Facebook all the time. I'm saying, oh, wait, I didn't see Jackie on Facebook. What's going on? But they didn't tell me. The next day I found out when I got an email. She said, I have had a very bad night and day today. Now, she's in Australia, so it's a long, you know, her timing is different from mine. Last night, I couldn't meditate at all. Headache, neck ache, pinging in my ears. Penis and bum visions. Penis and bum visions. You know, come on. Now, what the hell? She says, this time, and the worst bit was the feeling that needles were being pushed into my legs and arms, like when you have an injection that stings at the needles into your skin. And Janelle was telling me that she's going through something similar. This morning when I woke up, both my ear canals all the way down to my neck were burning, and there was a lot of pain. This lasted until about 1 p.m. They are itchy, feel full of fluid, but the burning sensation is gone, thank God. She did a defense meditation, and it did help with the burning and the pain. But this is the part that really irritated me more than anything. You know, when somebody sends me a vision of a penis or a bum, you know, whatever. Like, to me, it's like, what next? And I don't care to even know what next is, okay? Because I've been through a lot myself with these visions that they want to, you know, do to you. But then you start attacking the physical flesh because, what, the visions aren't good enough? She says, the very next interesting part of my day was when I went on Facebook this afternoon and saw your face, your avatar picture. I started to feel very negative emotions of hate, jealousy, basically that you're evil, that I need to walk away from you. You're dangerous. I can do better than you for a friend. You're a user. You're using me. I mean, Charlene, some very bizarre stuff. Now, in my nature, I don't think like this about anyone. So I know it's not me, and I thought you should know that this is being projected to me. Every time I saw your picture, I would have these emotions come flooding over me. I am not a jealous person, and I don't think the worst of people. This was very hateful stuff I was feeling. I don't even hate my ex the way I was feeling today. I can't even send hateful energy back where it comes from without sending love and healing, too. It's just not in me. In the end, I said, I can make up my own mind about who my friends are. Thank you. And I just walked away from Facebook and the computer. I went and had a salt bath and did some cleansing of my aura before I came back to write this all down for you. So overall, a really bad day. Really, Charlene, about this. Really sorry about this, Charlene. And please believe me, this just isn't me. I am quite upset about it. Well, of course it's not her. Of course it's not any of these women. Of course it's not Shep. I mean, there's so many people that have emailed me about things that they've gone through, but now it seems like they're using me as an excuse to go after these people because, what, they're out in the universe, they're trying to enlighten themselves, they're trying to be metaphysical, so they're using these horrible, you know, images and visions and saying hateful things to them and using me to do it too. You know, to me, this is so childish. It's so immature. And I'm thinking in my mind, you know what? You're in mind power. This isn't something that just anybody knows. This is mind power. This is something that an enlightened being would know how to use. And you call yourselves enlightened? You know, this is not enlightened. As my friend Kim said years ago, this is endarkened. This doesn't make sense. Because I don't do anything to anybody that I think was going to come back to me. And for them to be projecting this kind of stuff to people who are just doing what they can to help themselves to have a better life, this is asinine, you know, because what, they think it's going to not happen to them? You know, you're setting out a thought in the universe that you can go after anybody that you want to, and you think you're not going to have any repercussions for it? That's asinine. So I wanted to tell you that, yes, if you get messages in your mind that I'm some hateful being that you're supposed to not have anything to do with it, please let me know, okay? Because I am starting to get a group of people together who are very enlightened beings, and we're fighting this. We've had enough. And I wouldn't want anybody to be put through anything just because they've associated with me, or anyone else for that matter. Okay? Hugs and peace, everybody. Bye-bye.